About a year ago, I shot a video on using HO-scale buildings and N-scale, which the buildings are really N-scale buildings just sold to HO users and really not marketed towards us, even though in the past they were originally sold as HO buildings, such as this one right here. It used to be a Concord building, which is now sold as an HO building when it came to life as an N-scale building. Also, you have stuff like this AHN building, which is actually an HO scale building, but the dimensions actually make a better N-scale building than they do HO. So something you can look up and use that too. There are many HO scale style buildings that you can use at N-scale, and I'll talk about them in the video to follow. It's time to save you guys some money. Getting buildings in N-scale is rather hard sometimes. The industry even just doesn't help us out. They do some odd stuff. So this is building here, this Leech Memorial Hospital. And it has a couple other things that you can make it a hotel and etc. This box here is from 1987. If you try to get this is a hard to get model. On eBay, they sell anywhere from $60 on up to $100 for one of these buildings. You know, it's by Concord, it's no longer made. But here's something that a lot of people don't know. A lot of companies resell their molds, their machinery and everything, and remake stuff and everything. And the manufacturers aren't out to help us out as model railroaders and N-scale. And so what they end up doing is lying to us. I'm going to show you a lie, and you can find this a lot. So if you go to HO Layouts, bring your handy dandy little ruler right here. It's an N-scale ruler. It's got HO on it and all that kind of good stuff. So we looked at my people before, and you can take the little ruler here and you can see that most of these little N-scale people are about 6 foot tall. So I'm just going to leave this here for an example. What you find out is, for instance, this company here, Helgen, bought a lot of different molds and everything from different companies. This building looks the same as the Leech Memorial Hospital. Different color. But if you go to the Walters, here that building is. It's called a high-rise building kit. It's a Helgen plastic kit. It's listed at part number 322-1713, HO scale. It's a lie. It's not an HO scale. They put HO figures and stuff in front of it. So you'll take your building, you'll take a ruler, and you'll pick, like right here in the bottom story, line your ruler up, and you'll just take it to the bottom of the next window, and we're looking at about 9 scale feet in N scale, which is rather reasonable. So you hold up your little people to it, pick your people up, put them behind the window. As you can see, it looks pretty reasonable in height. You can tell you might be able to bluff this as an N-scale building. And we know it is, by the way. If you're not sure, flip your ruler around to your HO gauge, which is right here. That's where is it at here. HO, and do the same thing. Mark it at the bottom of the window to the top of the window. So an HO scale from this floor to the next floor is 5 feet. This is how you can tell whether it's basically an HO scale building or an N scale building. Just take a ruler and look at the stories. You know, most buildings are going to be about 10 minimum on up per level. You know, 6 foot, 8 foot, there's no way it would work. So what we'll do is we'll take this Helgen kit, which is listed as HO, and we'll look at some of the parts. So we look at the actual print sheet here. It's pretty much the same graphics. The colors are different colors. But HO N-scale, Let's put it together upside down. Like that. Pretty much the same kit. It's just molded in different colors. We'll put those out of the way. And really, this is all it is the same repop of this kit here. So we even pull out this window glass here. Flip it over. And you can see that the numbers on the glass are even matching. 171376. 171376. And scale HO. This is another good piece to look at here. The HO building, the N scale building. Granted, they're both N scale. But you can see it's got, on this one here, the Leech Memorial Hospital from the original pop it was. Now they call it the Grand Hotel. The Grand Hotel, restaurant, nightclub, hotel, etc. So, they're just lying to you. I don't know what is the deal with Walters or Elgin or all these companies that are actually listing N-scale buildings as HO. So you HO guys ought to watch out for this too, because you can end up buying buildings that are in reality N-scale buildings and too small versus HO scale buildings. Even if you look at the instruction sheets, it's an identical instruction sheet pretty much. They just changed the name from Concord to Helgen. You know, I don't know why they did this, why it wasn't good enough to resell as an N-scale building, which it is. Let me put that back like that. And even on these boxes, when you go to the hobby store, look at the boxes and look at, so this building here, they put the HO scale car in it, the HO scale people, but if you look at the people, they're taller than the windows and the doorways. That's a dead giveaway. So my advice to you, this is, like I said, you cannot get this building, usually if you look at eBay, for under $60, and it usually ends up selling for close to $100 for this Concord right here. Same building. Get yourself the HO catalog. Look it up. This little power station right here. Pull it up. If you look at this, see the doors, and then look at the car. They list this as an HO scale building. You know, 2011. It's an N scale building that they put larger cars on there, and they're trying to sell it to HO modelers because there's more of them as an HO scale building. It's not. It's an N scale building disguised as an HO building. This oil storage tank is hard to get. It's the Walters oil storage tank, obviously, in N scale. But I actually think this is actually an HO scale building, which is modified to be an N scale building. And let's look at this kit really quick here, and I'll show you why. It's the ladders that come with it. See this upper railing here? That's an HO ladder. And to fix it, what you do is you trim off that upper railing, cuts it down in half, and lo and behold, it becomes an N-scale kit. You can look at some of the other parts too. The manway on this is gigantic. So my guess is this is actually a modified HO building, because there's no windows or doors. So if you're looking for anything like tanks, the modular series that Walters has out, the tanks, I've actually got some of them, and they will actually make really nice N-scale buildings. The other tanks I have, I picked these up at a swap meet. These here are actually HO scale buildings. I don't know what kits they're from or who makes them. But if you look at the top, it is an HO scale manway on it. The panels are pretty large, the rivet detail is pretty large. But the person who did these, all he did was he added an n-scale ladder to the side. Same with this one here. If you look at it, it's got the HO scale manway on it. All that, it's large rivet detail. But you put an n-scale ladder on it, all of a sudden, it's an n-scale tank. And as we know, tanks like this, the larger fuel tanks, are really hard to get in n-scale. So what you might end up doing is looking in HO scale and look for their smaller tank storage facilities and everything. Buy some, actually these are plastic ladders. Buy some etched metal ladders off of eBay or wherever you can get some from. Put a ladder on it. You know, cover up the manway, do a little bit of extra work on it. Hide the fact that it's an HO building and you have a gorgeous n-scale tank. Plus, it's large. You know, much larger. You know, you're looking at HOs probably about that big. But if you look at an n-scale car, which is half the size, it's much more appropriate in scale than it would be in HO scale. So that's another way to get buildings from HO. Even in N-scale, you have scale issues. For example, this is the lifelike state prison building. You can see I cut the top off. This building here is another example of a way off scale building. This is, I'd say, is a Z-scale building. If you're in the Z-scales, look for this. This would make a great Z-scale building. But for N-scale, it's just way too small. Just if you just hold up your people to the front window there, you know, they're almost as tall as the entire building. Would be like way too small. And look at the front doors. If you look at the people to the front doors, you know, you'd have to get down on your hands and knees to crawl inside this. Another thing is you look at the loading docks here, the entrance. The semi-trailer is just way too big for that. The rear loading docks is the same way. That trailer is just gigantic compared to this building. So you do have problems with the N-scale buildings. But there are some interesting fixes to that. This building here is a 7-Up bottling plant. It's an HO scale building, and this is even before lifelike. This is an AHM building. So even though this is HO scale, this is more in tune to being an N-scale building, and I'll show you why. I'm going to back this camera up a little bit so we can look at it a little bit more. So to start with, the loading doors are more appropriate to N-scale. I'm actually going to use this building on my layout. If you just bring up a box car, because this part here is a little bit overscale, I'm going to cut this section out as if the doors are open, but I will run my two tracks into these doors here for two loading bays. And as you can see, it's almost a proper width anyway. The other issue, we'll get rid of this underscale building, is on the back, and it's a little bit hard to see here. The loading docks are a little bit too big. There's really nothing you can do about that. You know, granted, I'm sitting up a little bit higher on this than need be. But what you can do with that, you can take this loading dock off, cover it over, or whatever. I'm going to actually cover it over with some brickwork and stuff. It's just oversized, and it makes no sense if you're using these as two loading bays to have a set of truck loading bays on the back anyway. If you have a boxcar sitting in here, how are you going to load and unload these doors? The final thing about this building is you can look up front. And I'll get my little people out again. As we can see now, the doors are still a little bit short for these people, but it's much more appropriate to an N-scale facility with the people than it is for an HO facility. So if you really look at it, when they built this, backside, HO scale, and then they went with the N-scale front. So it depends on how you use it. And what we're looking at again is a 7-Up bottling plant. It is an AHM building, and you can find it on eBay. They don't make it anymore. Just look for it. That's how I got mine. Great N-scale building. But it's HO. Go figure. So one of the things that's going to help you out the best with your modeling is get by one of these. This one's a mascot, but it's a model railroader scale rule. Or, if you want to be silly, carry around some plastic people. But this is easier. Or even a piece of paper, just mark them off. The two things you're looking for to compare for is buildings is HO. And on the other side is N. So if you go and just measure the front door, in a normal building, most front doors are anywhere from 8 to 10 feet. So that'd be 8 to 10 feet in N scale. But if you do an HO scale, you'll probably get anywhere from 4 to 6 feet. So if you get a door that's 6 foot tall, or stories that, you know, are less than, you know, 7 or 8 feet in HO, the odds are pretty good it's an N scale building that's just disguised as an HO. And vice versa, if you get what you think is an N-scale building, and you look at it, and all of a sudden you look and it's like the stories are greater than 15, maybe 20 feet, the odds are pretty good you have yourself an HO building disguised as an N. And one of the things you guys got to remember is it's much easier to make an HO scale building into an N-scale building just by blocking off some doors, replacing them with the N-scale doors. Rick's products or Pike stuff, or what do you want to call it, sells N-scale doors, and there's a lot of other companies that sell N-scale doors. Block off the HO scale doors, put N-scale doors on it, and lo and behold, you have an N-scale building. It's harder to make an N-scale building look HO because it'll just look odd. You put a huge door on the side of something, you end up with, you know, headroom of like 8 feet, 4 feet inside a building. So, simple money-saving tip. Try it out and keep modeling. If you guys put anything together, you find any buildings that you know that are N-scale and not HO like they claim, like that power plant, post it up so other people can save some money on them. And there is a lot of the older buildings out there that they repopped as so-called HO scale buildings. Now that we're talking about HO and N-scale products, this little wall section is actually an HO wall section. You can actually take your ruler here and look at it. And let's flip it around here. And you can see the bricks are about 9 inches tall in HO scale by about, you know, foot and a half, give or take, which is basically your standard cinder block size. And if you look at an end scale here, you can see that the bricks end up coming about 3 foot long by about at least a foot tall. So they're big bricks. But for something like a retaining wall, freeway retaining wall or anything, the big old bricks like that would be fine. So, you know, I'm going to use this as a retaining wall of mine. It looks heavy duty. You know, it's not your standard household style cinder block wall, but it's a good representation of a retaining wall, you know, for a freeway section or, you know, anything that needs a little bit more beef behind it. And that's just by using an HO scale wall in an N-scale place. I hope this video helps you guys save some money and get a highly desirable building in N-scale. You got to look it up in the HO catalog, and there's several other buildings the same way where they're actually N-scale buildings listed as HO. So even with the N-scale guys, you buy a building that doesn't look right, It's because these manufacturers are trying to aim to the group of people they think will buy the most, which is HO, and they're just selling them an N-scale building. They ought to admit it it's N-scale and resell it as an N-scale instead of trying to disguise it as an HO kit, which it is not. So, hope this helped you guys out. $36 on Walther's. I've got it on $29 on sale. Or, if you want to, you can hold out for the original Leech Memorial Hospital on eBay. Hard to come by. Anywhere from $60 to $100. So, for the same amount, you can get two of the same building or spend $60, $100, get a classic. But if you're going to build and put on your layout, get the cheap one. It's the exact same building in the same kit. And remember, it's just not these buildings here. There's other buildings the same way. I don't have a list of all of them. It doesn't take much to turn an HO scale building into a good N scale building. Things like door changes and stuff, but a lot of it's already been done for us. It's just the marketing is marketed towards HO scale. You know, simple things like on a tank farm, most of those tank farms that you can buy in HO scale, you cut the handrails down to half height. They may create N scale buildings or tanks like fuel tanks and oil tanks, but they look better in N scale because they're more correct size. They've actually reduced them down a little bit for HO scale. Well, either way, enjoy the video. Like I said, I shot it a few months ago, actually a year and a half ago, I should be honest. Just haven't had time to publish it. So might as well publish it now. Enjoy it, and thanks for watching.